So in the last video, I introduced to you the problem of least squares. The problem was that we had some noisy data that we thought could be fit by a line, and we needed to figure out how to draw the line. My daughter just drew it by hand, but we should have a more systematic way of doing it, and we're going to use matrix algebra in order to figure out that systematic way. So the general problem is that we have the equation AX equals B that is an overdetermined system. That means that there are many more equations than there are unknowns. The unknowns here in the least square problem is the y-intercept and the slope of the unknown line. So from a vector space point of view, what that means is that B is not in the column space of A. So what we want to do then is to solve the problem where we project B onto the column space of A. Now, how do we do that? Well, I'm going to write now that this B, we can write as the B that's projected onto the column space of A, plus the piece of B that is perpendicular or orthogonal to the column space of A, which we can simply write as B minus B projected onto the column space of A. Right? So B is split into two pieces, one that is projected onto the column space of A, plus whatever is left over. So whatever is left over should be orthogonal to the column space of A. So this piece here is orthogonal to the column space of A, right? If something is orthogonal to the column space of A, that means it's also orthogonal to the row space of A transpose, right? Because the rows of A transpose are just the same as the columns of A. Now, a vector that is orthogonal to the rows of a matrix is in the null space of that matrix. So therefore, it's in the this vector here is in the null space of A transpose. Okay. So we write B as a sum of a vector projected onto the B projected onto the column space of A, plus a vector which is in the null space of A transpose. So to get rid of the vector that's in the null space of A transpose, we just multiply both sides of this equation by A transpose. So we get A transpose A times X equals A transpose times B. And then when we do that, we've multiplied by A transpose, then we've gotten rid of the stuff that's in the null space of A transpose. This system of equations are called the normal equations. And in fact, these have a solution now for X. And as long as the columns of A are linearly independent, which they are typically in a least squares problem, then you can also show that A transpose A is an invertible matrix. So we can invert it. So we can write this as X is equal to A transpose A inverse times A transpose B. And then we can multiply both sides of that equation by A. So we could have AX equals A times A transpose A inverse times A transpose B. And the right-hand side here is actually equal to the B projected onto the column space of A. So this very fancy looking matrix here, A times A transpose A inverse times A transpose, is called a projection matrix. Okay? So that matrix projects B onto the column space of A. So A is not an invertible matrix, right? If A was an invertible matrix, then you could use the rule of the product of matrices inverse. But A is not even a square matrix, right? A is, in the case of the least squares problem, A is a n by 2 matrix, right? But the A transpose A is a square matrix. A transpose A is invertible. And then this quantity, this matrix here, is what's called a projection matrix. OK. This is just kind of an aside to show you the linear algebra of this problem. The actual key, though, are these normal equations right here. And that's what we're going to use to find the least squares line. So let's look at a sample problem, a toy problem. So let's have data. So let's say we have three data points that we want to draw a line through. You know that 2 points, you can always draw a line through 2 points. But if you have 3 points and they're not collinear, you can't draw a line. So let's have data of 3 points. 1, 1 will be one of the points. 2, 3 will be the other point. And then the third point will be 3, 2. OK? So let's write down then the equation AX equals B for these points. So we have our line, right? We're trying to fit our line Y equals beta naught plus beta 1 X through these 3 points. So our equation then is the Y is the Y values. So 1, 3, 2. Right? And then our matrix, the unknowns are beta naught and beta 1. And the matrix here is going to be 1 times beta naught plus x1 times beta 1. So x1 is going to be 1. And then 1 times beta naught plus x2 times beta 1. x2 is 2. And 1 times beta naught times x3 times beta 1. x3 is 3. OK? And that's our system of equations, trying to fit the line y equals beta naught plus beta 1 x through these 3 points. So these are our y values. And then we have beta naught plus 1 times beta 1 equals 1, beta naught plus 2 times beta 1 equals 3, and beta naught plus 3 times beta 1 equals 2. So this is an overdetermined system of equations. There are 3 equations and only 2 unknowns. The points are not collinear, so there's no solution. So to solve this, then we form the normal equations. So the normal equations, if you allow me to flip the order, because I'm so used to writing AX equals B, let me change the order here. The normal equations multiplies both sides by A transpose. So we have A transpose is 1, 1, 1, 1, 2, 3. The first column becomes the first row. The second column becomes the second row. So A transpose times A, which is 1, 1, 1, 2, 1, 3. A transpose times A equals A transpose times Y. So that will be A transpose times Y. So we have 1, 1, 1, 1, 2, 3 times y, which is 1, 3, 2. So this is the normal equations. A transpose times A equals A transpose times A transpose A times X, sorry. A transpose A times X, which is our beta naught beta 1, equals A transpose times B. Okay? Those are our normal equations. So we can do a little bit of arithmetic here. So we have 1 plus 1 plus 1 is 3. 1 plus 2 is 3 plus 3 is 6. 1 plus 2 plus 3 is 5, 6. And 1 plus 4 is 5 plus 9 is 14. So this becomes a 2 by 2 matrix times beta naught beta 1, our unknown vectors, the y-intercept and the slope of the line. And the right-hand side then is 1 plus 3 plus 2 is 6. And 1 plus 6 is 7 plus 6 is 13. Okay? So these are the normal equations. The A transpose A, X equals A transpose B. So this is solvable, right? This is a system of two equations and two unknowns. We can use any method to solve this, including Gaussian elimination, but it's only a 2-by-2 system. Or you can see what the solutions are. I have my solutions written over there, but let me kind of guess it here. I think beta naught is 1, and beta 1 is a half. So 3 plus 3 is 6, and 6 plus 7 is 13. So beta naught 1, 1 half will solve this, right? So this solution is beta naught equals 1, and beta 1 equals 1 half. Very nice numbers because I set up the problem so that the numbers are nice. So the best fit line then here is our y equals 1 plus 1 half x. And that's the best fit line for these data points. Okay? If you look at the notes, you'll see the graph and get an idea of how good this is. So this is just a toy problem, one I can work on the board. So we only have 3 data. But typically in a least squares fit, you have a large number of data that you're trying to fit a line through. So let me review. What I did in this video is to solve the least squares problem. AX equals B is an overdetermined system of equations. So the idea then is to project B onto the column space of A. We can do that by multiplying both sides of the equation by A transpose on the left. And then we end up here then with what's called the normal equations, which is a solvable system of equations. So A transpose A then is a square matrix, invertible square matrix, and this equation can be solved. So in practice, what you do then is you set up your equation AX equals B. The unknowns are beta naught and beta 1. And then you multiply both sides by A transpose. And then you get a solvable system. And using a computer software, say, it's very easy to solve for beta naught and beta 1 and to get the line. So I told my daughter when she drew her curve, her line by eyeballing the data points, that she needed to do it more systematically. But I didn't teach her all of matrix algebra to do that. She'll have to wait till she goes to university before she learns that. I'm Jeff Chasnov. Thanks for watching. And we'll see each other in the next video.